machine, but she went to wardrobe.
Wardrobe? But you have her costume right there.
I know, sir. But she said it was all wrong. She needed a more updated look, more pizzazz for the leading lady.
What? Ladies and gentlemen, I am terribly sorry about our delay, but you see we're having a little trouble with our...
Mr. Spielman! I'm ready for my close-up! Paige, where did she come from this
way?
Fellows, my camera for the night.
Lisa's supposed to be married!
Break a leg. Break a leg. Someone told her to break a leg, and she did. I tried to help, sir. I called 1-800-BIG-START. And they said they had just the star we needed.
What?
That's right, sir. They said they had a leading lady who could even add her expertise.
Listen, be on the camera. My contract is specified. I can only show a song. And Mr. Spielman.
Page Dog Steiner.
Notice clause 56.
I'll need my own dressing room. Big star.
Number 57,
big star. I do not call animals or children.
So can you say,
big lights?
The kids and the magazine must go. And finally, number 58, spaghetti. Lots of spaghetti. My dear friend, Sophie Morgan, taught me something valuable when she said, all I owe to spaghetti.
No children and no manger scene at Christmas?
And what is with the spaghetti?
She's clearly overestimating the power of pasta.
Paige, get her out here. Now, Cass, just stay calm. I've seen this before. We've just got to get a few things straight. Ladies and gentlemen, bear with us, please. In a few moments, we will have the cameras rolling.
You call?
Yes. Sophia, regardless of your contract, the spotlight in this show is on our Savior, Jesus. Now, it's all about him humbling himself and being born on earth. Children, I mean, we must also humble ourselves if we want to be used by God in the show or in life, period.
got carried away.
Sophia, the kids in the manger scene are staying, and that's final. The author would want it that way.
Well, clear out of my way. Now look, I've been in a lot of really big shows, and I mean really big. And believe you me, I know how it's done. And I've never heard of this. Humble yourself, get down, and then you're up, thing.
Miss Sophia, think of a seesaw. One side is down, and that's the human side. And when we humble ourselves and realize that we need God, the other side can go real high, and we can do anything God wants us to.
Miss Sophia, can you act humble?
Of course I can act humble. I can fake anything. You want humility? Well, then show me the money.
Well, you can't fake humility because God knows our hearts.
Just stop it, Sophia. Stop it. Stop all the acting and pretending. Just look in the mirror. Can you live with yourself?
Sophia, I was just like you. And one day, I just stopped all the games. Follows ways.
And we learn to develop our character by learning to walk and talk like Jesus. You see, he's our example.
You want me to be like this baby?
That's right. It's all here. Just read the script. You'll find all the answers.
Oh, no, they're going to sing again!
Sophia. Do you even know what a hypocrite is? It's one acting a part, a character in a play. Now the Bible warns us about hypocrites, Sophia, those who act religious, and he doesn't want us to have anything to do with them. Now I'm sorry, but you just don't have the right attitude to play Mary.
Never in all my shows. You know, we have a contract. I am to be a star.
Well, I can't just allow you to walk out of here.
But my contract states!
Mr. Spielman, just a minute, Mr. Spielman. We think Sophia would make a great star. Just if we only...
Oh, that's perfect. Sophia, why don't you go with these lovely young ladies to wardrobe and they'll fix you right up.
Now remember, girls, I need to wear something bright and glittery.
Of course.
Mr. Spielman, what are we gonna do? The critics will be here, and they're gonna give us a terrible review without Sophia. They're expecting her, sir.
Well then, Paige, that's just the price we're gonna have to pay. Now look, God has given us a marvelous chance to share this with the audience. We need to take a stand. Be faithful, servants. Now it's not two thumbs up from Siskel and Ebert that I'm after. No, it's what God thinks that counts to me. We want heaven's applause.
This traveler has brought you myrrh. It's the appropriate thing.
Wait, frankincense makes sense to me. It's magnificent for deity. Mine's imported. Who could afford it? No one but me.
Hi!
like it, we thought it'd be cool to get a little tension going as to which one of us is offering the best gift to the baby Jesus.
It'll give it a new twist, a little greed and pride struggle.
It's just too boring as written. We come in, set our gifts down, we're out of here.
Sophia suggested we ham it up.
Sophia.
And we thought about it, Mr. Spillman, and we think she's right.
We want our time center stage too.
Yeah.
Guys, guys, you are the three wise men. Don't be fooled. You've listened to her, now you're acting like her. But we're going to do it the way it's written, right here in the Bible. Let's review. The wise men search for the star, and when they find the star, they are...
overjoyed.
Yes, they are overjoyed to find the star, which will lead them to the Christ child. And next, they
worshipped him.
Right, they got down and they worshipped the baby for who he was, and as a part of their worship. And then they present their gifts. Remember what we learned earlier?
That's just what Mary said when the angel came and told her she was going to give birth to Jesus.
Yes, yes, that's right. And Paige, Mary knew that God would see her through. And Paige, he'll see you through too. Now go on, go get ready. A shepherd and wise men ready? Okay, we're ready. No, I mean it, we're ready. You've watched behind the scenes and we've taken care of a few small matters. And now, we proudly present our Christmas special, A Star Is Born!
Thank you.
shepherds and wise men to a small village called Bethlehem. The baby Jesus was wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. It was an ordinary town until our Savior was born there. His light can change our ordinary lives into something extraordinary. Even today, just follow the star.
Star of Bethlehem. I just want to tell you, these guys have worked so hard, and I want to applaud them because they were great tonight. They were smiling, and I am so proud of each of them. And I want to thank each of you parents for letting them be a part of our choir program. It has been a true joy to be able to share this time with them. And even our little kindergartners back here, they came in at a couple of weeks before, and they were the children from around the world because we all come and celebrate and worship Jesus. And I just want to thank you, boys and girls, from the bottom of my heart. I love each of you, and I want you all to have a very Merry Christmas.
Program, and we want to give you this as a token of your appreciation.
Lord, we want to give you this as a token of our appreciation for helping us learn this program so quickly. We love you.
Miss Light, we just want to thank you for working so hard with us in our lines and just being here every Wednesday night, an hour later, part of your time to help us work on our lines. And I just thank you very much.
It's a blessing. I would like all of our children's choir workers, if you're children's choir faculty, if you would stand up, because I tell you what, folks, we do not have a children's choir coordinator, and so they're kind of just on autopilot this year, and they're doing great. So I want all our, if you're a children's choir worker, if you would stand, come on, that's you, Mary, all Kim. And if you see these folks in the hall or sometime in the next week or so, just let them know how much you appreciate them working with our children. And children, y'all did wonderful. We are so proud of you. Let's all stand together. Let's give them another hand. May God richly bless you this Christmas season. Merry Christmas.